on a warm summer's evening, on a train bound for nowhere, I met up with a gambler. We were both too tired to sleep, so we took turns of staring out the window at the darkness, till boredom overtook us, and he began to speak. He said, "Son, I've made a life out of reading people's faces and knowing what the cards were by the way they held their eyes. So if you don't mind my saying, I can see you're out of aces. For a taste of your whiskey, I'll give you some advice." So I handed him my bottle, and he drank down my last swallow. Then he bombed a cigarette and asked me for a light, and the night got deathly quiet.
What's up, YouTube? It's D-Mac the Monster 420 here, and we are here with the first ever episode of Grandpa's Camper. We had the fire going. Unfortunately, it started to rain. If the rain lets up, we're going to move back outside. Unfortunately, we came in inside the camper, which is not that bad. I like being able to sit. I don't have to hold the camera, and I can just concentrate on asking questions.
Well, before you do that, I think you better show them the fire. You mentioned it. You might as well show it to them. All right. On with the interview.
So we got 17 questions of early childhood. This is the first ever...
17 questions of early childhood, okay.
This is the first ever episode of Grandpa's Camper. We're going to try to shoot 1 to 2 a week, depending on our schedule and our time of being able to get together and do it. We live basically in the same household, so it shouldn't be that hard. So the first question that we have for early childhood, number one, when and where were you born?
Oh, well, I think that's an easy question. When was 1959, September 3rd? Where was the Central CMG, Central Maine General Hospital? Now it's called Central Maine Medical Center.
Question two. Do you recall any interesting stories regarding your birth?
No, not during birth.
Question three. What is your earliest memory?
He remembers this one. Yes, my earliest memory, according to my mother, who doesn't, till the day she died, didn't believe it, is I was laying on my back in the back seat of a car, and all I could see was the passenger side out the window and the back side. And all I could see was snow as high as telephone poles. That's all I could see. Snow everywhere, as tall as can be. And I was only 2 weeks old, my mom said. And she says, "No, you cannot remember that because we were going to see your uncles in Stratton, Maine." That's my earliest.
Question four. Who was the most influential person to you as a child?
Olivia Newton-John.
Why?
Her voice was magical. She was gorgeous. And the way she lived her life, I thought was pure until she did Grease. Grease changed it all for her.
Question five. What adjectives would you use to describe your childhood and why?
Ooh, he's getting adjectives he wants. How many do you want?
Three to five.
3 to 5 adjectives. Adventurous. Um, writing. I'm not sure that's an adjective, but writing. Exploring. I was always learning about the woods. Woodsmanship? No, that's not adjective either. Forestry? No. It's kind of hard to answer that one. But I think I got three of them.
Question six. How would your parents... Okay. Sorry. Question six. How would your parents describe you as a child and why?
My father had nothing to say about it because he refused to acknowledge that I existed or I was his. My mother, on the other hand... Repeat the question.
Question six. How would your parents describe you as a child and why?
Describe me as a child and why? My mom would say I was a troubled child. I was out of control. And it took everything she had from killing me for me to learn things. Like I said, my father wouldn't even acknowledge that was his.
Question seven. Did you have any pets as a child? If so, what kind and their names?
Oh, my pets were always cats, and I cannot give you their names. Well, there was Patches. She befriended me when we moved into High Street when I was 12. I left my bedroom window open, and it was over a roof, and somehow she got in and laid kittens on my bed. I can't forget her. Other cats through my life is beyond childhood.
What did you do during the summer as a child?
Oh, got in the woods. I was either out in the woods, out in the barn, typing my novel. One of the things I was doing.
Question nine. What was your favorite game as a kid?
Kickball. Loved kickball. Bat and tetherball. But I think kickball was my favorite. Tetherball was damn close.
Who was... Oh, sorry. Question 10. Who was your first best friend as a child?
This is going to be a funny story, if you guys get it. My name is Robin J. Greeley, Sr. I befriended a boy whose name was Robert John Glossett, Jr. So I was RJGS, and he was RJGG. I mean, RJGJ. Oh, yeah. He's about one of my first best friends I ever had. Can't forget him. Though he didn't like me after I come out of the Marine Corps. He said I became too bossy or something.
Question 11. Did or do you have any nicknames?
Yes. My mother called me Bimbo. That's off an Eddie Arnold song. A 45 that was on the back of Four Walls. The back of Four Walls of 45 was Bimbo, and my mom called me Bimbo. I received my recent nickname I use, because I like it a lot, Grease, when I was like something like sixth grade.
Question 12. What were you most afraid of as a child?
That's a little tough question. Wow, you got some good questions here. What was I most afraid of as a child? Well, after 9, it was spiders. Before 9, okay, it's like I was spiders, because I can't think of anything else before that.
Question 13. Do you recall any interesting stories related to you by any of your elder relatives that you have never forgotten that you think are worth telling? I can read it again.
I think I got it. You want to know if there's any stories from my past that my relatives, older relatives, like grandparents or mothers and fathers, that would... go ahead and read it again.
That you think were interesting.
I would think...
Do you recall any interesting stories related to you by... Stories that were, like, related to you... By any of your elder relatives that you would have never forgotten that you think are worth telling. So stories that other people have told about you that you think are most notable.
And that is a question I'm going to have some difficulty with because I've developed an antisocial problem here, and I really don't know what they've talked about me, but I could tell you stories about me, but no, I cannot honestly answer that question, honestly.
And his face lost all expression, said if you're gonna play the game, boy, you gotta learn to play it right, you got to know when to hold them, know when to fold them.
Question 14. Describe your parents. What were they like? What did they do?
Hi. My mom, she was a strong woman. She had to be because she was bringing up 8 children with 8 husbands, but let's not get this wrong here. Even though she had 8 husbands, only 3 of them gave her children. She's funny, witty, absolutely highly sexual. She was also a person in her younger years had a singing ability. She used to sing on the radio. Grandma used to say that if we stuck temp cymbals between her knees, we could hear her rapping off as she sang. That was my mom. She ran away from home at 12 years old because her father was physically abusing her. Not sexually, physically. Just, you know, beating her up and stuff. So she left at 12 years old to move to Lewiston to see the frogs driving cabs. She was disappointed when she came down here and saw only men driving cabs. Now, my mom fell in love with my father when she was 13 years old. My father was a country singer who sang festivals, bars, reunions, whatever. He became popular over the years. And at 35, she became pregnant and had me. Dad says, nope, that don't belong to me. I don't want to go any further into that. A lot more questions. I think I answered it better than I was supposed to, but I apologize for that if I did.
No. whatever you have to say, part of the question is okay with me. So question 15, Where did your father work? What is your strongest image of your father?
Well, like I said, my father was an entertainer who sang in bars, festivals, whatever he could find. I guess you call him a honky-tonk man. And he was pretty famous. He made $14 million. And the strongest image of my father? Well, I guess the biggest picture I got of him is coming down Birch Street, getting ready to pull onto Park Street next to the Acme Snowshoe Club with his new wife in a red convertible with chrome. That ends that.
Question 16. Did your mom have a job? What is your favorite memory? Okay, yes. Question 16. Did your mom have a job? What is your favorite memory of her?
Yes, my mom had a job. She worked at Falcon Shoe for many years, and she had two jobs. Her first job was to push carts around the shop, take empties, put them away, take fulls, put them where they're going, you know, where they're supposed to be going, and that was her job. Her second job was taking care of five children, and believe me, it was not easy. I was the worst one of the five. There were three older than me, but that was my previous marriage. I became adopted, and I became a Greeley, and I was the oldest of the five children that she had with her, and no, it was not easy. Even with her husbands that she had through the years, it was not easy. She did her best. She was both mom and dad and a cart pusher. And they called her the Road Runner.
Question 17. Describe your grandparents. What did you enjoy the most about them?
Grandpa Holden is the only grandfather I ever known. He had a place off Spring Street, and it looked like a camp. My grandfather, I remember him eating the gristle of chicken, which Grandma used to complain about all the time he would do. And he was the first one to teach me slapjack. Grandma, Wiles O'Berry, full-blooded Blackfoot, I think the best thing I can remember from her, and my favorite thing from her, is she told me that you're going to learn something new every day. You know what? I have. And I'm almost 60 years old myself, and I've still learned something new every day. She was cantankerous, but she was also fun-loving and giving. Grandpa, I wish I knew more about. He died when I was like 6-7 years old.
So that was the last question. Could you state your full name and your age for the record?
My name is Robin J. Greeley, Sr. Or I could say my name is Robin J. Winslow Greeley, Senior, and I am 59 and 11 months old.
Run, you never count your money when you're sitting at the table. There'll be time enough for counting when the dealing's done. every gambler knows.
You know what? What we got started going here is supposedly a Esquire interviews of this old man's life. Now, well, if you like this first episode, I suggest that you hit that bell to be notified, and hit that subscribe button. And then you tell your people and your friends and your family, why is this old man? This guy's interesting. You do that. Because if you don't, you know what's going to happen? The beast is going to come and invade your Fortnite account and just delete it. You'll be dead.
The secret to surviving is knowing what to throw away, knowing what to keep, because every hand's a winner, and every hand's a loser, and the best that you can hope for is to die in peace.